Yeah, we'd like to welcome everybody to another episode of What's in Your iPad podcast. We are the producer group. We sample everything. We got a special guest on the episode today. Mellow X is in the house. What's up? Say what's up to everybody,
brother.
How
you doing? It's Mellow X.
Yeah.
The one and only.
Welcome.
Yeah, we're definitely humbled to have you on, man, to take some time out of your schedule. Thanks, Cheese, for setting us up. We appreciate it, man.
Yeah, man.
I gotta thank him because, he was in a Sound on Sound interview and shouted out Beat Makers of Squad. And, literally, like the day after, the subscribers. And the dope shit about it was he was mad humble about it, right? I hit him to say thank you. Like, he ain't even hit me on, yo, I shouted you out, some type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, somebody passed it on to me. He was like, oh, you got a shout out, da 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 da. Now I hit him and he was like, oh, you seen it. That's what's up. And was just kept it moving. You know, that shit is dope. Like, he wasn't even trying to toot his own horn or not like that. You know, so I appreciate that.
I just support the motherfuckers is lit, man. I learned a lot from your tutorials.
Appreciate it, man.
With Beatmaker 3 and putting my mind into just like an iOS producer mindset, tools to use things. Anytime I was searching specific shit, your name will always pop up. I was like, all right, let me go to this page and run through all your videos and shit. So anytime somebody asks me, I just, I'm honest with who support me and shit, whether I know them or not. Or who inspires me or whatever. So that drew me to your page. Fuck with all of this, everything.
Yeah, that's much appreciated, man. Much appreciated.
So what you doing out here, brother? You doing some work out there? What you got going on right now?
I live out here. I live with me, my girl, and my son. We live out here, and we've been living out here for 4 years. Same shit. I just, work from home. I do a lot of music production as far as the different artists. I've been working on a lot of films now, film scores and shit. Just creating my own shit. I have a Patreon dropping too called Multipass, giving a lot of gems and just archive material I have and shit. So I've been out here working on that.
I'm sorry. You use the iPad on the film stuff, man?
Yeah. I do. I use it. I basically use it on everything now. I produce everything I produce a lot in iOS, and then I'll either stem it out to Ableton or somewhere else, especially when I gotta put it to picture. Sometimes I'll just run the iPad through the laptop, so it's on some audio interface shit, and then watch the film, and then I'll just use the iPad to sequence around it. But at some point, everything, unless I'm putting it straight to SoundCloud or some shit, everything kind of makes its way to some kind of mastering thing, whether it's Ableton, whether it's whatever I have on the iPad. But I kind of mix it around, man. It just depends where I'm at, you know. But right now, all of my sounds and everything I've been building been from the iPad first, then maybe to Ableton after, then over here. But
yeah, just depends on the day, depends on your workflow.
Yeah, depends on what I'm working on.
Yeah, I saw it on the crate.
You know what I mean?
On the crate, you had the iPad and the Mac. I was like, man, this is hot. If I use the iPad, I use it by itself, right? I've always thought of the iPad as something you take separately out. But I was like, oh man, it's not even rocket science, man. But putting them both together, man, it's like, oh yeah. The power is right there because you have the touch interface and you can, audio interface and all that.
Yeah, when I first was fucking with the iPad heavy, because I knew about this and music and sound on the iPad for a minute from the jump, but I didn't dive into it until maybe Beatmaker 3 or something like that, where it was there's an app on my phone I could fully, maybe iMachine 2. I made a lot of shit on that before I went to Beatmaker 3, but so what I do is I run the iPad through the Mac, so I open it as an audio interface Ableton.
Okay.
So that way it's kind of I'm using Ableton because I use Ableton as well, but I'm really using the iPad. I'm just kind of like running it through Ableton. Like sometimes I'll loop in Ableton and then just, you know, do iPad and then next track, do another one, next track, do another one, and it builds up until it's like a full beat of stem.
Like a tape deck. Ableton. Yeah.
I'll do it like that. Sometimes I'll just build the whole shit in Ableton. But when I first started doing iPad shit, that's what I was gonna say. I was also like, I'm not bringing nothing to the studio with the iPad. Mm. I got to a stage where I was like, can I only bring the iPad to studio and kill shit? Like, let me test myself. Like, you know, once I got real good, and then I was like, all right, let me just bring my phone. Like, I'm gonna just bring my phone. So I got to that, and once I got to that point of like, okay, I know it inside out, it's like, okay, now this workflow of Ableton, Fruity Loops, or other shit, like, let me use it, you know, all together, and I separate it just for me and my workflow.
Hey, you didn't take your phone onto the film set, did you? Did you do the film work on the phone?
Yeah, I do, because like, if I'm not producing it on the phone, I'm either gathering sound, building my own sample library, you know, I'll like scream or some shit and then put in, pitch it, fuck with it, and it becomes whatever. You know?
You can't be that.
All depends, yeah.
I was gonna ask you, what are your top five favorite apps in iOS?
Yo, that shit change all the time. Y'all ain't gonna but I would say right now, the ones that I've been going to, let me get my iPad actually. I'll be right back, my phone.
Yeah, please get it. Word. Yeah, I want to get to run straight down.
I love when people pull their iPad out and just, it opens it up for mad conversation anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, plus that little bottom screen has whatever you've been picking up. Like your top ones go to a little bottom menu anyway.
Yeah,
I'm about to
three or four of me right
there. The menu kind of.
Yeah.
So Blocks Wave,
menu,
Aux.
Let's see. Like, Audio Share, like
number one, D-Mega 3,
Nano Studio 2.
So you still don't use the machine anymore? You still rock with it like that, huh?
Yo, you know what it is? I've made so much shit on all these apps, like man. I'll forget that I did like 10 joints or something on the iMachine like 2 years ago or something, and then I'll go back, stem it out, I mean shit. So I like going back to the app. So I actually haven't produced on the app in a minute, but I'll go back to it to see like old shit I did that I might want to sample. I kind of treat it like a sample, like I got my own sample and shit.
But yeah, a lot of those apps too have good sounds in them. So I'll go back to a lot of apps just to get sounds and export them out.
Five, I mean, those are like the IMPC 2. What happens is I'll get into a groove of like the last month or two, every day I was making something on the IMPC 2. Just like, you know, I'd be into that for like a month, and then I'll go to like Word Gadget. And like, so just going, and then I'll go. But a lot of it makes its way to Beatmaker 3, because that one I could kind of like automate shit and I could really get busy. And then from Beatmaker 3 is like, if it needs to, it'll go to Ableton, and then I'll like master, blow my little master plugins and shit. You know what I mean?
Hey, I got a question, man. What do you do for your data management, man? Because you're talking about a lot of waves right now. So you're talking about stemming out a lot of like little wave parts. You can't. It has to be like audio, right?
My 2 terabyte hard drive right now on this laptop maxed out. I got like four terabyte hard drives almost maxed out. I got
Audio Share. Dump them out of Audio Share.
Yeah, Audio Share. Okay. I just use the Files app since I have the cloud shit. So I can just and then delete it.
So like, how much stuff stays on your iPad? Well, I guess you take it off and then until you forget about it and you like go back to stuff.
I pay for like the most space you can have
on cloud.
I do some shit that I only save on like iCloud and certain things. So
I got you.
I feel like it hasn't maxed out. I haven't had that issue.
That's cool.
Yeah, that iCloud is clutch.
I got the cheapest iCloud. I haven't started using it like that. So I use those Western Digital that my Passport Wireless.
Mm-hmm.
And back up everything like that. But I do that for the film stuff too. So like my camera shots.
I don't always keep it on there. Mm-hmm. I kind of use it as like a middleman to get to my laptop, which I can
okay.
to the hard drive.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I got you.
I think I'm the only person that don't use it. I got a keychain that's like a little thumb drive. The shit is like 256 gigs.
That's little I did when I started working with the iPad more is I stopped DJing with Serato. I still DJ with Serato, but I started putting most of my music on a drive so I could just like plug into Pioneer. They have like record box and you could just do all your playlists and it has like a Pioneer system. So I didn't have like I just didn't like the aesthetic of showing up with my book bag. I wanted to just show up, plug in, rock out, and plug, go get a drink. I'm chilling. I don't gotta think about the equipment, this and that. So I fuck with the Flash. If I could have that for the iPad, I know they do, but I haven't delved into that yet.
Do you use any of the DJ apps?
Yeah, I use the main one I use is Track. The first one, not the second one. Second one is whack.
I agree with you 100%.
The second one's just like a regular DJ at like all the other ones. Like hard, but the first one, like it got the freeze function and you could chop shit. I could show you right now. Cause I'll be fucking with shit in there. You know what I mean? Like
on the iPad?
Yeah, these are the iPad DJ apps. They got some cool ones.
Yeah, you use a Bluetooth controller too? Yeah, that's what I'm about to say.
Nah, I do everything just on here.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's Traktor. Mm-hmm. And I like it because it has like this function. Where is that? I'll show you real quick. So like this.
Yeah. Like repeater functions.
Yeah, you grab it right onto it.
Even when you're playing.
Mm-hmm. Not control.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how.
And so I just be spazzing on it, but I use controllers sometimes, but I really like. I would look to just be like on the.
Do they see you? So if you're
like in the future, they just go look at niggas like, yo, niggas
on the. These are like a little piece of glass, right?
Be, but I get busy on the turntable. That's like where I'm at home though. On here is more like I mix good or whatever, but I experiment more. So I'll record with Traktor. You could record your mix. So I'll like record a loop of some cool shit I did and then sample it.
Okay. Yeah.
Save it as like or something like that.
Uh-huh. Yeah. You ever tried the EDJing app?
Let me see if I got it.
They have so many, you know. The one thing that sucks is since Apple put that lock on all of these songs, you can't even bring songs in from there.
Or DRM? Yeah,
the DRM on everything is, man.
I used to use Virtual DJ, and I used to be able to go to the iTunes for crates. Yeah, then I think they stopped that too. Yeah,
they stopped it on all of them.
You know what else they stopped too? Like, so remember, you used to be able to like record the screen and then take that video, put it into audio share, and pull that off. Mm-hmm. Put that shit in audio share right now. Be a flat line.
Really?
No audio. Wait, you can't do it. When did that change? Update?
I just tried the shit yesterday. Day before yesterday.
Damn, I can't believe they killed that, man. I used to do that all the time.
I haven't tried that in a while.
Yeah, no, I did it yesterday because I needed a crow's court.
How do they know? I tell you what. No, but no. So you have to be able to import a video, but they probably just don't want screen capture. Just rename it.
Like, that's the man. Anything.
Yeah. No, I tried renaming it, and as long as it's a screen capture, I haven't tried any other video that I downloaded anything yet, but I know for a fact, like when I did that, it ain't work. But I like I missed the workaround because I refuse to pay that $10 for that Tube AU because I feel like that Tube AU is gonna get shut down eventually because Apple's gonna realize why am I?
If you have it already, they can't take it off of you.
No, that make it not update though.
Yeah, I think it's just gonna be to a point where it don't work. You know what I mean? Like, cause it's been out for a couple years.
That thing is beautiful.
I was tempted to buy it yesterday, but I was
quick.
And that's that. I was tempted to cop it yesterday, but I was like, nah.
I'm not tempted by it
because I know a lot of times.
I don't know if y'all off the subject, my fault, but the audio share shit, that's how I first got connected with you. I don't know if you remember, but I had asked you, like, yo, how do I get the YouTube shit? I asked you, how do I get YouTube shit? Like, I want to sample YouTube shit, and you told me, like, yo, go to this site, and then use, like, YouTube download, use it in the Docs app, something like that. Yeah. You just gave me, like, the cheat code, but that's how I first got put onto you. And I hit you up, you hit me right back with the info, too. So, yeah.
Now we use it so much because I was saying how like that if you screen record now and then you take the video and you put it in audio right, that shit don't work no more. Like,
is it safe to say Beatmaker 3 is your favorite app right now?
Yeah, Beatmaker 3, definitely. I'll say I have done the most work in there, and the most work that has been used, I would say. Yeah, the most shit. Like I did for Jay-Z for his 444 tour, I did all the it's called interstitial. So like in between, he did his show had three parts. It was like act one, act two, act three. So there's an intro, and then after each act is like a small film. So it's three films and I did all the music for it. And all of that I did on the iPad. Starting doing the whole project there, then bringing it into Ableton to like sync with video and complete it there.
Yeah.
And also there's a film called Queen and Slim that came out last year.
Yeah. I saw that.
So I did the trailer for that film. If you look at like the official trailer, the beginning of the first like main beginning part of it is a mix of like Ableton and Beatmaker 3 or whatever. But at the end, like right at the end when it shows, you know, it builds up at the end in trailers. Mm-hmm. And that beat that plays is a full Beatmaker 3 beat. I even use my own sounds from Splice in it. It's like a whole Beatmaker 3 beat, and then I just put in Ableton, like mixed it, whatever, but I didn't really add anything from Ableton, like all iPad.
So you probably don't really even see a lot of other sound designers even using the iPad like that either, do you?
I don't, but I'm sure people do. Mm-hmm. You